Montague's statement. He gave the statement in the year 1917, to be specific, in the month of August. What is the importance of Montague's statement? He said that the government's policy is of an increasing participation of Indians in every branch of administration and gradually develop self-governing institutions with a view to a progressive realization of responsible government in India as an integral part of British Empire. So let's decode this. Montague says that the policy of the government is intended to increase the participation of Indians in administration. That too, in every single branch of administration, the government is looking forward to increase the participation of Indians. And secondly, he says that the policy of the government is to develop the self-governing institutions in order to ensure that there is responsible government established in India, which is an integral part of British Empire. So he now prefers India as an integral part of British Empire, and he is willing to establish a responsible government in India and increase the participation of Indians in the administration and develop the self-governing institutions. So 3 points: increase participation of Indians, next point, develop the self-governing institutions, and third point is to establish a responsible government in India. Then India is referred to as an integral part of the British Empire. So what is the significance of this statement? From now onwards, after the statement is given, the demands which were put forward by the nationalists for the self-government or the home rule were no more treated with the seditious charges. Because Montague was saying that the policy of the British government in India was to increase the participation of Indians, that is, to ensure that the Indians themselves became a part of the government. So all the demands that were being put forward by the nationalists regarding the self-government or home rule were no more treated as seditious. Since he clearly stated in his statement that the attainment of self-government for Indians was not the government policy. Whereas in 1909, when Morley gave his statement, it clearly meant that the reforms were not intended to give self-government to India. But now in the year 1917, there is a small deviation from the previous statement which was given by Morley. And that was about the reaction from Indians to the Montague's statement. Indians did not receive Montague's statement well. In fact, they started objecting his statement. Why? There was no specific time frame given as to when Indians would be allowed to participate in the administration, as to when the self-governing institutions would be developed, and as to when the responsible government would be set up in India. Since no time frame is given, we have put forward our resentment. And secondly, we were absolutely not okay with government alone getting a chance to decide upon the nature of the responsible government and the timing of advance towards the responsible government. So Indians were highly disappointed that the Britishers would decide on what was good for India and what was bad for Indians. So that's about the Montague statement.